Hi, I'm Alejandro Hoyos, and today we are at Berlin at the launch event of Intel's Core Ultra 2 series, also known as Lunar Lake. And right now with us, we have Lyle. Hi, Lyle. How's it going?
I'm doing well. Thanks. Good.
Okay, so what do we have here? I see a lot of Thunderbolt and a lot of devices, so tell us what we have.
We have some great technology here. First off, I want to start with right here. We've got this great Samsung Core Ultra Series 2 laptop. So great performance, but also great connectivity. So check this out. So, you know, when I go to work or even at home, I really like to be in a comfortable space when I do my computing. And so for me, I like having a large monitor, full-size keyboard, and mouse. And how I can do that is I use a Thunderbolt 4 dock in that case, connected to my Core Ultra Series 2 through the Thunderbolt port. So in this case, I'm using this OWC dock, and it's providing me video, data, and power. So this is also charging my laptop all at the same time. So I've got a 4K 240Hz monitor, right? So it's great. So, you know, I get this workstation-like setup for me, right? But, and you know, this gives me opportunity, right? I've got my email running over here. Maybe I've got my Adobe Illustrator up. Maybe I'm doing some PowerPoint. So I've got all this real estate, which is really great for me to be productive. But you know what? In a lot of cases, whether I'm a creator, gamer, business user, or even just a regular consumer, I may have another PC that I want to use. And I just don't want to unplug everything to use that. Right. So check this out. I'm actually got another Lunar Lake laptop over here. Mm-hmm. And since I have the new Thunderbolt Share software loaded on both PCs, I'm going to show you how I can use that PC over this without disconnecting anything. So with my Thunderbolt 4 dock, I've connected this laptop. And I have a downstream port with another Thunderbolt cable. And I'm going to simply take this cable, plug it into the Thunderbolt port on this laptop, and it's going to immediately start setting up a high-speed Thunderbolt network connection between this PC through the dock to this PC. And once I do that, now it's going to give me a menu opportunity for all these different tools. And it showed up on both PCs. So you can see here, I can control the other computer, drag and drop files, sync files and folders, or even migrate data from an old PC to a new PC. Let's see it in action. So I'm going to hit control the other computer. And what's happening is that I'm going to be able to see that desktop. And here it is, it came up. So now I can move this around, and you can see when I move my mouse, I'm moving my mouse on that PC. So this is great. I can actually maximize this. Let's see what I was doing. In this case, I was actually running some Stable Diffusion software. You've probably seen a lot of it now here at the Lunar Lake launch. So what this does is takes text and creates a vector image, generates some different ideas for me. Mm-hmm. So what I've done is I've created these different panda examples because I wanted to do a coffee shop logo for somebody. And I actually saved one out. So I've already got a file saved out, but it's on this computer.
Right.
Right? I need it over on this computer because remember I'm running Adobe Illustrator over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up again my Thunderbolt Share main menu, and you can see it's got drag and drop files. So I'm going to click on this and it brings up an explorer that I can see both file systems of both PCs. So here's my Samsung, and then you can down here on this pane, I can see everything on my MSI. So, and since I'm actually on the desktop, I'm gonna take that file, Panda 1, simply drag and drop it, and it immediately transfers over to this PC. What's nice is I didn't have to get out an external storage, right? It just happened, and at the speed of Thunderbolt. So now I've got that. I've got my Adobe Illustrator here, so I can do open, and if I go here to my desktop, open it. Now it's going to open that file, that vector file that I did in VectorFX by Distinct AI. So it's kind of cool, right? Think about it. I am not only am I multitasking different applications, whether it's my email, my Adobe Illustrator, my PowerPoint. In this case, I'm actually multitasking multiple PCs at the same time, being super productive, a better workflow for creators, gamers, regular users.
That's pretty cool, and you can all control that, you know, like a docking station right here, connected through this, the Go dock.
Yes, absolutely, and the nice thing is, you know, I can go full screen, I can even take over the monitor if I wanted to, right? In this case, now it looks like I've actually got that computer on this screen. No, that's but I'm really running it through Thunderbolt Share in that case.
That's pretty cool. And what about the future? What can we expect?
That's a great question. You know, you've probably all, you know, this is showing you over Thunderbolt 4, but we've also got Thunderbolt 5 devices coming to market very soon. And I just happen to have a couple of Thunderbolt 5 SSDs. So this is coming out here very shortly. This is a Thunderbolt 5 SSD by OWC, and this is a Thunderbolt 5 SSD by Sabrent. Which is great is that these work great with Thunderbolt 4. So these are completely backwards compatible. And with Thunderbolt 4 PCs, such as these Lunar Lakes, they'll be 25% faster than a Thunderbolt 3 SSD. So going with a Thunderbolt 5 gives you 25% performance boost over older Thunderbolt 3 SSDs. So great technology that even allows you to do more with these great technologies of Intel Core Ultra Series 2.
That's awesome. Thank you. All right. I appreciate it.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.